We've had periods in our history where we've been very polarized. But what's really interesting about this form of polarization that we have today is that it's not just one or two issues, it's every issue. This polarization is really ripping the country apart on so many different levels. So Better Angels wants to be a force for really going in a different direction.
All of our goal is to come here and share what we think on a difficult topic. The number one rule of this floor is that you will say what you believe.
It really just began with a sense of concern about where the country was and wanting to do something that really was not being done, which is, can we talk with one another rather than simply at or about one another?
That's very important. There are no teams here. We are a group of people and we're trying to figure out what's true about this question.
Better Angels debates are really interesting in part because they eliminate hierarchy.
I'm looking for a speech in the affirmative.
The moderator has clear rules about who gets called on and how long they get to speak and how many questions are asked, and everyone is equal.
Is there a speech in the negative?
It's really a collective search for what you think to be the truth of a situation. Rather, they're trying to defeat your opponent.
Everybody walks in, contributes what they have to contribute, and the group sort of thinks together, and you can express pretty differing opinions, but ultimately you know everybody's there trying to figure out an answer to a tough question.
It's beautiful to see because people have different experiences, different capacities, and everybody has their thing to contribute to making it work.
Patriotism in the extreme is the willingness of the individual to sacrifice.
And it has nothing, in my mind, to do with patriotism.
It's important to keep these conversations going, to not get trapped in your ideology.
Now I can see and appreciate how people associate nationalism with patriotism, which was not something that I did before.
We should not talk about markets, but the real social consequence of expanding the state.
But we can do it as a matter of philanthropy. We can do it because it's our choice.
This is not just a human right for the people who can afford it.
That really attests to how sincere and thoughtful and natural the environment was, that I could find myself comfortable to participate in such a short period of time.
I didn't feel like my opinions were going to be shut down or looked down upon.
There was so much genuine interest in what everyone had to say. I thought that was powerful.
You really have to dig deep and hear other people's personal experiences as well.
I enjoyed how much it showed that, yeah, at the end of the day, no matter how opposing the opinions are, there's just so many things that fall under common ground that we can all agree on.
It's we the people. It's up to us as citizens to lead our nation together. We don't have to wait for some high up person to make the decisions for us. One of the wonderful things about this is that with training, anyone can do this.
We're finding that these debates are really popular with high school and college students, and also with adults in communities around the country.
It's meeting a need. It's meeting a need that people feel to express themselves and know what they think about the issues that really concern them, and form better relationships with one another, including the people who don't agree.
I'm surprised that everyone was very mature.
Yeah.
Better Angels exists to bring people together to rebuild trust, to rebuild the civic fabric so that we can be one country again.